What's going on, guys? Welcome back. So today we have a fun workout. We test our strength with clean and jerk and snatch. So we just got done with our strength program. We actually just finished yesterday, so our legs were a little tired after going really hard on the first day. So this workout does have full commentary the entire time. So we'll go over that later in the video, but first, we do have an important meet in 2 months from about 2 months. So instead of me telling you about it, I'm gonna let the founder do that for me.
Hi, my name is Adler Edwards. I've now been cancer-free for 18 years. So I'm the founder of Kilos Against Cancer. I started this organization to be able to give back because of how fortunate I was with my situation. When I was born, there was a type of rash on my body, but the doctor didn't really know what it was. We went to Duke University Children's Hospital in North Carolina, and there was a doctor there, but he was kind of amazed and never saw a child that was born with this type of cancer. I was born with Langerhans cell histiocytosis, which is a cell disease attacking itself, its own organs, and immunity systems. I went through about a year and a half of chemotherapy. My treatment was pretty much experimental. We saw that that wasn't working, that wasn't doing what it should have. Bone marrow transplant is seen as the correct thing to do and what's needed to change the bone marrow and the cell structures to be able to not attack the rest of the body. My sister Kiona donated the bone marrow to save my life. Whenever I would eat something, my body would just automatically reject it, and a feeding tube was the only way to get the nutrients into my body. Even after the treatments and after I was declared cancer-free, I would continuously have to go back to Duke University. Seeing all these babies and young children, I knew that they had cancer and they were going through treatments. To see some of those kids go through their treatments and now be cured and be able to live a regular life is amazing. Sometimes what we go through in our regular lives isn't such a big deal, and we really shouldn't take everything for granted. Not everybody's as lucky as I was, but nobody should die or be affected by cancer in a negative way. Everybody should be able to recover and return to life in a normal way. Kilos Against Cancer is a charitable organization which uses the sport of Olympic weightlifting to gain awareness and donations towards cancer research. When I originally came up with the idea, I messaged Patrick, who's the owner of Keep Pulling, and automatically he offered for me to be a special weightlifting session in one of his events. Everybody supporting has just been amazing. If you want to help out, you can follow us at Kilos Against Cancer on Instagram. That's where we're going to have all the posts about our upcoming events. It would really help if you just shared. You can also go to our website, kilosagainstcancer.org. And if you want to get more involved or help even more, you can email me at kilosagainstcancer@gmail.com. None of my doctors thought that I would be competing in weightlifting when I grew up. They thought I'd have health problems and I wouldn't be okay to be able to do what I'm doing and live your life to the fullest, because not everybody has that opportunity.
Okay, so we start off with a 75 here. This one was a pretty good one. It wasn't too bad. Then we moved on to 78 and we started to be on our toes. We continued to be on our toes when we moved back down to 75. But we moved up again to 78, and my coach told me to sit in the squat longer rather than trying to get up right away. What do you know, it worked, and I had a good lift on that one. So we moved the bar up to 80 kilos, did the same thing again, sat in the hole for a little bit longer. That was the max we did there. We kept it light just because we were focusing on my form rather than strength. So we started off with a 100 clean. We are doing a clean and power jerk because I just want to work on my power jerks right now. Then we moved on to a 105. That was pretty good. We're also doing power cleans here. This was a 108. The power jerk was not too bad. A little wobbly. You kind of see the wobbliness on this 110. Another power. Then this jerk, it's a little wobbly. Moved back on my heels. This was a 113. This is our first miss on the squat jerk. A good power clean, and we just couldn't hold it again. It was a little wobbly, so we got to be more stable in that position so that we can hold it above our head. This 115, I did a full, and we tried the squat jerk, but kind of just rode it down and just couldn't hold it. We do the 118. This was our first full. Good full. And this one, there was really no chance of getting. Just kind of, I caught it, but it rode all the way down. Now we move on to our single cleans. This was a 120. Pretty good. Here's a 123. On this one, a couple other ones as well. The 123 was all right. We need to have our second pull higher. See how we're getting it on our thighs. So when it hits our thighs like that, we need to, on the second pull, pull it closer to our hips. In that hip crease, the power position, we need that second pull to be a little bit higher, and I think that'll make the weight go up, because then my third pull will be a little bit better and everything will kind of just come together. So I think that's what we need to start working on.
Since young and now we dreamin' of getting rich. Look at me, my nigga, fantasize about a white picket fence. It's the trees, my nigga. Used to want a pathfinder with some tents. That's all I need, my nigga. Throw some 20s on that bitch and get it rinsed.